Obviously, the thing that truly draws your eye about any Harley is its motor. The Heritage Classic is accessible with two sizes of huge V-twin -107 cubic inches and 114 cubic inches, or 1753cc and 1868cc for the people who didn't get the Foster Brooks reference. In case you're a red-blooded God-dreading person who cherishes opportunity in farm dressing, you'll most likely fondle constrained to horse the batter for the bigger adaptation. However, the fact of the matter is the execution contrast isn't that awesome. In the two cases, you get a motor that completes an okay occupation of adjusting the desires of a Harley with the desires of a cruiser that isn't a Harley. In other words, there are sure things we anticipate from the Harley encounter. You expect roll. You expect a tad of shake. These things give the bicycle a completely extraordinary and quintessential character. In case you're a Harley hater, you'll see these things as flaws. They're not. They're mark components. You wouldn't go to a Metallica show hoping to hear a pack of the Ween spreads, okay? In the meantime, however, in the event that you went to see James Hetfield et al., and all you got was 2 hours of that automatic rifle riff from One Who Leave with a Migraine. Along these lines, Harley has put extraordinary exertion into building up a motor that riders who are not Church of Harley Orthodox can likewise appreciate. It's renegade, however not terrible. The shakeout of gear everything except vanishes once you kick it into high gear, and the Milwaukee 8's effective torque conveyance takes the prize when contrasted with the more casual nature of Indian's Mark power plant. All things considered, you'll need a quiet throttle hand when riding in the rain. Harleys don't accompany footing control, which, when joined with the by and large poor wet climate execution of most cruiser tires, can make for some elusive minutes in the storm.